13. This is like possession music.
I have no idea what they're saying.
Six is angry music. It's just Viking metal. It's just Vikings.
She was like, oh, we're gonna listen to Pitbull. And I was just joking and I said, oh, let's listen to Viking metal. I was involved with a person who loved Viking metal. And it's just, it's really like fast and it's like, Odin, guard our ships.
Seven, eight, squeeze the glutes on the way up.
We had it on and it was like, yeah. It was really intense. And then after a while it was like, okay, let's turn it off because it just sounds like pure evil.
I'm gonna play church music after.
Oh my gosh.
Like, I was at a 10. As soon as I walked in, I was like, let's do this, let's go. I just wanted to have fun and just be silly.
She saw her in your car and thought it was a person.
That's 10. Funny.
It's funny, like sometimes we go in and me and Ellie both be in like joking moods.
Did I show you how to pop your booty in a handstand?
It's like funny and Kareen kind of gets like, guys, this is serious.
Attention.
I'm being serious.
Notice I have the clips on? That means we're serious here. Like, I feel like a little kid in like first grade that gets in trouble for talking.
But I was like, whatever she's gonna give us is gonna be hard, and I just wanna just make it as fun as possible. So we giggled a lot. We did a lot of giggling, and that's fine.
There's certain days where she should appreciate us laughing and joking, because there's other days we wanna shoot her. Like,
what I'm gonna give you is gonna be hard. So, all right, are we ready? Then we went outside. It's probably about, I don't know, 85 degrees out and super humid. And we did walking lunges with a barbell on our backs.
First of all, I want you all to know this is Zach's idea. All right, we're going outside. I will be kind to you when you come in.
You're gonna get real dramatic in a minute.
Because it was so muggy out, it's so gross out. And then all of a sudden the sun comes out and I was like, this is a bunch of crap.
Because Allie loves when bars are on her back.
Yes, Allie does not like bars on her back. Sorry, I apologize, Allie.
I used to have a big problem with walking lunges because of having the bar on my back. And I didn't like having it on my upper back because I had all this tension and all this junk happening and I would instantly have a headache. But since getting adjustments and since getting massages more regularly, I didn't have any of that pain on Friday. So I was prepared for that and then I was like, oh, I'm fine. But I just don't want to be outside in this muggy grossness. I'm already super sweaty.
Sometimes it's fun to be mean. But when your butt's sore later, you're gonna thank me.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are. All right, so. They complained just a little bit. Not too bad. I would have complained too. We have a little bit of an option here today.
What?
We're gonna do. Oh yeah. So we're gonna sit under the anchor point. We're gonna toe in. You're gonna put your top foot over to the front. Even out your feet. Make sure you're next to the anchor point. You're gonna come up to that side. Plank. Arm comes up. Crunch it in, and then out. In. And then out. All right?
What was the other option?
You said there was gonna be
just
options.
Just a side plank.
You said there was gonna be options.
You did say there was options. All
right. Right there, right, oh, Allie, I don't wanna hear it, you can do it.
I was just saying, you said there was gonna be two
listen,
options.
So we're gonna do 10 on each side, these are hard.
Oh, the side plank with a knee in? Yeah, that was ridiculous. The TRX is really hard, and then she's like, she told us we had two options, and she only gave us one, and I was like, what's the other option?
To stabilize yourself.
You can do it.
Of course we do kettlebell swings because I can't just not do that. I don't know. It's a full body, but it's like I'm doing a lot of glutes and stuff. It just takes your butt from here, puts it up here.
Thank you.
They're doing really, really well. I mean, their strength and their work. I mean, the workout they did today, it was hard. You know, I mean, no breaks or anything. So we build some pretty strong people in this gym. So I have here kind of stuff to make for my meals for the next couple of days. I have some fresh chicken breasts with no antibiotics. The raised cage-free, I believe before he was made into fillets, his name was Derek. He lived a very good life. He's very friendly with all the other chickens. I have some beef eye round sandwich steaks because I'm on a big steak kick. I don't know if it's because of grilling season and all that kind of stuff, but I'm really into steak right now. So I'm gonna probably mix it up and do like lunch, dinner, dinner, lunch, probably make some sort of egg white steak omelet at some point. No cheese, I'm not doing dairy. I have some tuna in water, and I do the packets because I don't like canned anything except for beans, which I rinse. I like to have these on hand after the gym or just in my purse when I'm going on excursions, whatever, because it's a good source of protein and omega-3s, and I get to have it immediately. All my friends think it's gross, whatever. I have spinach because I eat spinach with just about every meal, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I also like to, I have a juicer, and I like to juice using spinach and kale. And I have some cucumbers here for in the morning. I'm going to make a juice in the morning with spinach, cucumbers, beets. Never had them before, but Doug Funny thinks that they're pretty tasty, so I'm gonna try them out. Grapefruit and carrots. I'm gonna try and make something with it. Grapefruits as a snack. And I have avocado because what I want to do is, I wanna cut it, got it on Pinterest. I wanna cut it, take out the pit, kind of make more of a hole, get two eggs, plop them in there, bake it. Little bit of cayenne pepper and eat it like that. I'll be getting my healthy fats, my protein, amino acids, all that good stuff. I have portobello mushrooms here because I'm going to make chicken burgers later on that I have at the house. I still have some ground chicken breasts. I want to use the portobello mushrooms as buns. And I think we have tomatoes at home. I hope we do. Because I'm going to use that. And I have bananas here because I like bananas. Potassium helps with muscle recovery, helps when getting cramping, alleviating the cramping. I also want to add that to my juice in the morning with some oatmeal. I also want to try and make protein pancakes with my oatmeal and my bananas. And then I have spicy brown mustard because right now I can't get enough of it. It's 50 milligrams of sodium I think I sweat enough that I can have a teaspoon of it. And it's about 5 calories. And there's turmeric in it. Turmeric. I don't know how you say that, but that's good for detoxing the liver. It's also good for muscle recovery and alleviating cramping in muscles. And that's what I have here today.
Because I work Sunday through Wednesday, normally those are the days I prep a little bit more, try to figure out in advance what I'm eating, because when I'm home, obviously it's easier for me to grab something and cook it. But to be honest, my mom cooks for me. She usually grills chicken and stuff for me, chicken or steak or my protein, mostly because I'm lazy, or she just does it better. Mom always cooks better for you. That's how I feel. My mom cooks better than I do anyway. If I need to, we always literally have an abundance of chicken. Like when I make a grocery list or anything, it's like chicken, and protein, some sort of meat. So we always have an abundance. If I really need to grab something, I could grab it and cook it real quick. But yeah, she makes me, usually on Saturdays, because she doesn't work on Saturdays, she'll make a bunch of chicken, she'll grill it up, or steak, depending on, usually it's chicken though, or I've been eating a lot of salmon lately too, so she'll grill that too for me. She literally grills everything for me, but I can't complain. So yeah, and then usually I'll make, sometimes I'll make like a salad in advance, because the salads always go too. I mean, it's easy to make and easy to grab. And then most of the stuff I get is stuff I can cook quickly. Because honestly, the hardest part for me during meal prep is I get sick of eating the same thing, or like, I know I have this in advance, but I really just don't want that. Like, I'd rather have something else. So I tend to get things that I can just cook quickly. All right, well, first off, I'll start with breakfast foods. Breakfast is usually the same thing for me all the time. It's always egg whites. egg whites, and then I usually do 2/3 cup, which is about 3 egg whites, or a little bit more than that. Yeah, like 3 egg whites with 1 whole egg. So yeah, that's usually my protein in the morning, just because it's easy and it really cooks really quickly. And usually I have with it a whole wheat English muffin, and I'll put peanut butter on it because I'm addicted to peanut butter and I love it. It gets everything in, my protein, my carbs, my fat. If I don't want to do that, because sometimes I'm just really not, I mean, you get sick of things. I don't really want to cook egg whites all the time or have that, so I'll have oatmeal, and it's just plain oatmeal. And I'll usually mix in for my protein powder, which sounds kind of weird, and it's really not like the best tasting thing, but I have chocolate protein powder that I'll mix in. And then I'll put a little bit of peanut butter on top again, just to give it a little bit of flavor. Or I'll heat up frozen berries and I'll put that on top for it to give it like some sort of taste. But yeah, that's my breakfast. So all those take, like especially oatmeal, it takes like 2 minutes to cook up. So it's really quick. For lunch, normally what I'll do is I'll either have chicken that's already made, because that's obviously takes the longest. And I always get steamable vegetables. This is broccoli, but I also get like asparagus, green beans, that type of stuff. They take about 5 minutes in the microwave. You just throw them in there. And that's obviously easy because you can pick what vegetable you want. You can pick, I mean, anything. It just goes in 5 minutes. You throw it in while you're getting ready before I'm going to work, I'll just throw it in there. Or if I have a salad, I'll usually make the salad in advance. Salad again, I get the lettuce that's already bagged, so it's easier to just grab, because cutting lettuce annoys me. It's too much sometimes. And then the small tomatoes are already cut, and then I usually put cucumber and pepper in it. So I mean, obviously you have to cut that, but again, that takes like 5 seconds to do, and usually it's made. Then if I do a carb for lunch, which I usually do on days that I'm working out where I do lifting, I do the brown rice, which they're minute cups, so you literally take them out and put them in for a minute. I have an abundance of these in the closet, like a sick amount of them. And then the other thing I always have is tuna. Tuna's always easy, just open the can, eat it right like that for me. I didn't always like tuna, but I think I kind of forced myself to like it, to be honest, because I knew it was good for you. So I just started like, this does taste good, just eat it. So, yeah. And then for dinner, it's kind of the same type of foods, like chicken or steak or whatever you have for your protein. And then vegetables, or I do have fruit sometimes. I'm trying to figure out what different fruits have been affecting my body differently lately. Some foods now that I think I'm eating so clean, I get that bloat feeling in my stomach where I just feel like I'm like my stomach's sticking out to here, like it's like a rock in my stomach, and different fruits lately have been doing that to me. So I'm trying to figure that out. Exactly, like raspberries have been doing that. I actually love fruit. Like raspberries are my favorite fruit of all time. When I was little, we used to have a fruit truck next door, and I used to literally, me and my neighbor would go in there, buy big things of raspberries, just sit there and eat the whole thing in a matter of 5 minutes. Like I love fruit. But yeah, I guess that's just the downfall of things now. I mostly do salads just because it's more of a variety. Like it gives you all the different types of vegetables rather than just, oh, here's like broccoli. I usually don't eat carbs at dinner. I usually do breakfast, lunch. Yeah, I do get hungry. That's my thing. At night is the hardest time because during the day I stick to every 2 to 3 hours eating. And I also do in between all the meals, I'll do one. Usually when I train, I get a protein bar from there, and I have a protein bar after I work out. And if I don't go there, if I do something on my own, I'll have a protein shake mixed with frozen berries. I just do protein water and frozen berries. I don't put milk or anything in it. It just makes it taste a little bit better with that. Or I'll just take the protein shake just down. I also, at night, I get hungry because where I work, we're on a schedule with the girls, so we eat usually around 5:30. And then after that, I'll bring something to eat around 8, some sort of just plain protein, because at that point you don't really want crazy, or I'll bring some vegetables. And then if I'm still hungry, because I get out of work at 11, which sometimes I'm still hungry at that point, depending on what I ate during the day or how much I trained during the day, I'll usually come home and I'll eat like almonds. And I got this 100 calorie pack just because I love almonds, and I will eat a whole jar in one sitting and like have no problem with it. And obviously that's way too much like fat for you. So these are just portioned, right? So I'll eat one of these, or I'll eat a fruit or something. Or sometimes if I'm, depending on how hungry I am, I'll do a protein shake with a spoonful of peanut butter in it. Kareen told me one time that helps. It's almost like a casein protein. Like it helps the fat and the protein together help overnight, like with your muscles. So sometimes I'll do that too. Or sometimes I'll just have a spoonful of peanut butter.
This week I definitely just want to I really want to push myself harder. Mostly number one, because I'm going on vacation in 2 weeks, and I want to look really good on vacation, but I also want to look good for myself, and I really want to I want to do my pre-workout diet stuff before I do my workout diet stuff. What I used to do was on Mondays, because Mondays were my day off, I would have my meals, because I had my own Tupperware, I had my own living space. I would section out everything, so it'd be like Monday lunch and snack, and lunch and dinner, Tuesday lunch and dinner, and all that kind of stuff. Right now, it's because I'm constantly going and I'm home at weird times. It's the night before I cook for that next day, or like today I'm cooking for this afternoon and tonight. And I don't use tons of seasonings. I let the food do. Like when I have salads, people are like, you don't want any salad dressing. I'm like, no. There's chicken on it, there's shrimp on it, and there's all this other stuff. I just don't do dressings. Weirds people out, I guess. And we're I like to use cayenne pepper, because cayenne pepper is good for your metabolism and stuff like that, but that's about it. More like spicy mushroom. The closer I get to the show, it's going to be in the morning it's X, and then it's Y for a snack, and then it's C, and then it's A and B. And so the closer I get to the show, the more regimented it's going to be. Right now I have a little bit more flexibility, but I still pretty much stick to oatmeal with egg whites in the morning, spinach, and then for a snack I try to have half of a grapefruit, and then lunch I usually have some sort of protein with spinach and a sweet potato, half of a sweet potato, and then I have, I don't know, 14 almonds for lunch, as a snack, and then I have a protein and a green vegetable for dinner, and I try not to have any carbs after 2 o'clock right now. Right now, this week, I'm starting to keep my fruit to just the morning, and then I'm going to keep my proteins and the carbs to just, it's science. I'm trying to keep my carbs earlier in the day and then have more proteins and green vegetables and stuff like that at night. It helps me to lean out a little bit better going on vacation. So I want to make sure that when I see my pictures, I'm like, oh, all right. But it's also like kind of getting me in the right mindset for when I start really dieting down for the show. I try to just stay content with what I'm eating. Number one, I like mentally, I'm like, temptation is only temporary, and I like have my mantras. And then like making sure I'm like, oh, am I really just thirsty? Because a lot of people confuse that hunger feeling, that they're actually thirsty, but they think it's hunger. So I try to drink, you know, at least another 8 to 16 ounces of water, and then I'm like, okay, is it that I'm hungry though? And if my stomach's growling and stuff like that, I'm like, okay, well, I'll eat a little bit of something. And I try not to like eat this and that and this and that and this and that when I'm like, just need a little nibble of something. Because I will just slam food down my gullet and I'll just eat, 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 eat. So I try to, now I'm taking more time with my meals and I'm extending it to like 25, 30 minutes. So that helps with cravings a lot, is taking my time with my actual meals. Everywhere I go, there's a packet of tuna somewhere. it's gross. I need my protein. So I will put a packet of low sodium tuna in a gym bag, in a purse. If my clutch is big enough, I will bring a packet of tuna with me everywhere, because I get hungry at when it's time for me to have like an in-between snack or something, I'll just eat my tuna. And it is really uncomfortable when you're out dancing with friends and you're like, protein time, gonna eat my tuna. It's a better alternative than like at, you know, if you're like out all night or whatever and just eating like street meat or whatever. I find that eating my packet of tuna keeps me going. It keeps me well balanced.
It's just, I really didn't realize how long muscle building took. Like, I did not realize how long it takes to actually get just like one small little muscle. One of the things that scares me is I get really sick of what I'm eating, and there are options. Karina's told me that Allie's really good with like options for food and stuff, so I need to talk to her a little bit more, because eating the same thing for like 5 meals a day, every day, be like, I don't want this anymore. It's not even that I want like something bad for me. I just don't want that. Well, it's also hard too, because you can't cook things certain ways anymore because of like grease or fat or this or that. So the way you want it, you can't have it. And the other thing I'm nervous about is it being summer, being cookout season, going out with my friends. Kind of makes me nervous. My girlfriends will understand. They'll be like, oh, whatever, Jill's doing this, because they know I always do random stuff that they're like, okay, whatever, yeah, okay, Jill. But like my guy friends would be like, Jill, why don't you just eat a cheeseburger? Like, why don't you just eat this? I'm like, I can't. But I mean, eventually me saying no and giving them an attitude, I guess they'll probably end up stopping doing that. That's my biggest concern though, is being out or like having times when I just know I won't be able to do stuff because of the food or the drink situation. But now that I have Thursday, Friday, Saturday, those are 3 days of going out, and all my friends like are around those days now. A lot of my friends are teachers, so now they're not working. It's more into summer, like officially. So yeah, I think that's definitely affecting.
Mentioning earlier that like sweets and stuff are a major issue.
My thing is candy, Reese's, peanut butter M&Ms, any type of M&M. Anything chocolate, cookies, cookie dough, s'mores outside. I want a s'more and I want 9 of them, but I can't have them. But it's hard because my dad's also a huge snack person, and when my mom goes grocery shopping, she obviously buys stuff for him. Like if you go out in our kitchen, there's like brownies, like cupcakes, like all the stuff. I'm just like, really? Really? And sometimes I get mad, I'm like, why'd you buy that? She's like, well, your father lives here too. Like, he needs to have stuff he likes. I'm like, that's not fair. That's really not fair. And she's like, okay, Jill. And there's days I come home where from work late at night where I look at it and I'm like, I really want that. But I'm like, just go to sleep and it'll be fine. You won't want it anymore. And then I'll be laying in my bed and I'm like, I really want that cake that's out there. Like, my mouth is watering right now thinking about it. Sometimes my body really, really hurts, like especially my knees, but I don't always say how bad it hurts. Like you'll see my face, or like I'll reach down and just like grab my knee or something. The pains I get are like shooting pains through my knee. So like when Allie helps with like taping and stuff, it does like really help my workouts. But then she also helps because of what she does. I have like I have a lot of like knots in my back, and I have like the knee problem and stuff, and she always like knows what to do to help me with that, which really helps. Like she'll give me like a quick 5-minute massage, which hurts so bad, but it feels so good after. It's easy to talk to Allie too about things when you're upset, because she's very like, she's just like an open person. She's good with people, like, and she tells you, she's like, yeah, some days you're gonna feel like that, but other days you're gonna feel completely different. And like when I'm working out and she's like, oh, look at your back and stuff like that, like it does make me feel good. And she also, like, it's easy for me to talk to her about like contest stuff. Like she'll tell me like, oh, you're gonna have to do this with posing, you're gonna have to do that. Like she does, it's like a little insider. She helps. She like has down packed what she's doing. Like she knows, you know what I mean? And I feel like I'm so new that like the little things that like food and stuff, like I don't know. Like sometimes she'll come in and be like, oh, I hate this, and I feel like whatever. But like I don't know what to say to that, because I don't know. Like I'm like, that sucks. I don't know. I don't think Allie ever gets discouraged, because she's probably the happiest person I've ever met in my life. Like even when she's in a bad mood, she's happy. Like I don't understand.
I don't know. It's just sometimes I feel kind of like, like I know I'm strong and I know I've done this before, but sometimes I just feel like, not that I get pushed to the side, but it's just kind of like, I'm here too though. Like I'm doing a good job too. Can we just talk about how I'm doing a good job too? But so, I understand like Jill needs that reassurance and that positive reinforcement and stuff like that. And I'm told that she's doing an awesome job. She's doing, and she lifted a lot heavier on Friday, and I was really proud of her, but I was like, too, I'm doing a good job too. But then I noticed that like I will speak up a little bit more, or I'll roll my eyes a little bit more, or I'll mouth off a little bit more, because it's like I'm here too. And I need to make my presence known as well.
Yeah.
Which probably isn't the right thing to do, because it's like a small child acting out, but whatever.
Yeah.
But it's different when like I know it, because then when I'm like, ah, oh, check that out, like I feel like I'm just being cocky and I'm just like flaring my nostrils really hard, and then, but I want someone else to be like, hey, you mean?
Okay.
I get a little more motivated, and then it's like I want to try and do harder things. I really want to challenge myself, so then I can get that like that satisfaction. Like, oh my god, that was really hard. Like, great job.
Yeah.
So like last week I was definitely like, got it. And now this week I'm like, gonna own it. I'm going to kick so much A this week. It's gonna be stupid.